Hi guys, and welcome back to my channel. Today I want to show you how to create a presentation in Canva, then add multiple audio tracks to the presentation, select which page you want to play the audio tracks on, download your finished presentation as a video so that you can still listen to all your wonderful audio, and finally I'm going to show you how to share your presentation to avoid any damaging and costly copyright claims. I've got two fabulous free giveaways for you so that you can go ahead and add some really professional and creative touches to your presentations. So make sure you stay tuned. Until very recently, you could only add one audio track to a presentation. There was no way to adjust the duration of the audio track or select which pages to play it on. Basically, your audio track was added to all pages and that was that. The only thing you could really do was adjust the volume. But since Canva released some really exciting new features towards the end of 2021, you can now create some very varied and creative presentations to inspire your audience. So if you're ready to get started, follow me over to my Canva desktop. As you can see, I've already loaded up the Canva presentation template onto my desktop that I want to work with. And I've applied all 30 pages. You can see the thumbnails underneath. I have three audio files that I want to add to this template, two from the Canva library and one of my own voice recordings which I've already uploaded to Canva. For the benefit of those who aren't already aware, to add an audio file to a Canva presentation or to any Canva template for that matter, all you need to do is select the audio file from the Canva audio library and then drag and drop it into your file. The trouble with this method is that I can only add one track to the whole of my template. So one audio track will be played throughout 30 pages. And that's not really very good. However, using my latest Nikki Ninja tip, you can now solve this problem by adding multiple audio tracks to a Canva template. So first of all, keep this presentation open, then open a new tab in your browser. So you'll have two Canva tabs open at the same time. Now working from the new Canva tab, from the banner right at the top, I want you to click on Video. Now choose the video category from the carousel of images, and this is because the video has exactly the same dimensions as a presentation. And now you'll see I've opened up a blank video template in Canva's new video editor. I spoke about the new video editor in a previous tutorial, so do check it out afterwards by clicking the link in the description box. From the template categories on the left-hand side, you'll see that all the templates are now video templates. So I'm not going to be able to find my original presentation template that I wanted to work with. Well, it just so happens that I have another Nikki Ninja tip to help solve this problem. I'm going to click back into the first Canva tab that I still have open on my desktop, and this is my presentation template. I'm going to go right down to the bottom of my Canva desktop and click on Grid View. By clicking on it, Canva will open up all the pages of my presentation, so I have a kind of a bird's eye view of each page. Now I'm going to select every page by holding my cursor down and running it over each page, still holding the cursor down, until they're all surrounded by a purple outline. Next, I'll use my Mac shortcut key to copy the pages. Click back over to the second Canva tab that I've still got open. And again, use my Mac shortcut paste key to paste all those pages into this template. And don't worry if this takes a few seconds to complete because it's pasting a lot of information. And now, as you can see, I have an exact copy of my presentation template, which has been transferred perfectly into the video editor. I'm just going to get rid of this page. And now I can start using Canva's exciting editing tools from the new video editor to help me add multiple audio files to my presentation. For that, I can choose from a huge variety of music tracks in the Canva library. Scroll down and view each musical category. To open a category, just click on the heading or click on See All. You will need Canva Pro for this, since Canva has partnered up with Epidemic Sound. But don't worry, you can take Canva Pro for a test ride and explore all the wonderful features on offer by clicking on this link right here. I'll leave the link in the description underneath this video. I'm going to add the first of my audio tracks to this template by holding my cursor down over the track in the left-hand column and dragging it onto my template. And here you see I've now got an audio timeline. From here, I can access a menu of editing tools by going to the far right-hand end of my audio track, clicking on the three little dots to access the editing menu. From here, I can adjust the length of the audio track, I can adjust the volume, I can duplicate the audio, or I can just delete it. Unlike before, I can also select which pages to play my audio track on. Since I want this track to be part of my presentation introduction, I'm going to shorten this audio track so that it plays during the first two slides only. To do this, all I need to do is select the track with my cursor, grab a hold of the end bar here, and drag the end bar along the audio timeline until it stops just after the second slide. Fabulous! Now I want to add my own voiceover recording to the presentation. I did this by going up to the Uploads button in the far left-hand side toolbar, clicking on the Upload Media button, and then selecting my voiceover recording from my own device. If you upload your own audio recordings, they will appear under the Audio tab. And here is the recording that I want to add to my presentation. As before, I'm going to hold my cursor down to select the audio file and drag it into the presentation. Make sure you've positioned the video playhead, which is this black line here with an inverted triangle at the top, exactly where you want to add your audio. And now I have a second audio track uploaded to the same template. I want to finish off my presentation with a musical outro. So I need to make sure that the video playhead is positioned just before the final few slides. I need to go back to the Canva audio library, select the audio track that I want to add and drag it into my template. And it will appear exactly where the video playhead is. Incidentally, in case you ask, you cannot at the moment fade tracks in or out. But it's something that we have requested from Canva, so it may be a brand new feature that appears this year. So if you want to fade a track out, make sure you adjust the track by double-clicking on it and dragging the audio file until it comes to a natural end. Once you've adjusted an audio file in this way, make sure you click on Adjust to confirm your changes. Finally, once you're happy editing your presentation, you'll want to download the entire file as a video so you can still hear all the audio. So go to the far right-hand corner of your Canva toolbar and click on the Download button. Make sure the file type is set at MP4 video, which is what Canva has suggested. Select the pages that you want to download, and I presume that you'll want to download all the pages in your presentation. If not, untick this box here and then select whichever pages you want to download. Click on Done. Now this is the important part. If you intend to share the video file on social media such as YouTube or Facebook, and your file contains audio from Canva's library, you will need to connect the relevant social media channels. And this is all about Canva's One Design Use License Agreement. To connect your social media channels, just click on the link and select which channel you want to connect with Canva. Follow the instructions online, which are so simple and straightforward. Allow Canva to access your account. And then you're ready to download. Once you have your video downloaded, you're now free to upload it to your social media channels, share it with your colleagues, upload it to your website, whatever you want to do with it. I mentioned at the start of this video that I had two free giveaways for you. The first was Canva Pro, and the second one is a month's free trial to Epidemic Sound. Use this link to sign up for your free trial and explore all the beautiful music tracks, as well as a huge selection of fun sound effects, which I really love. As a YouTuber, this gives me access to a huge library of music, and it also gives me peace of mind knowing that I can use these music tracks without being hit by copyright claims. While you're waiting for my next video, why not check out how to add professional transitions to your Canva presentations? And I also have an entire playlist of tutorials to help you create better presentations using Canva. Just click on the links right here. In the meantime, thank you so much for watching, for your support as always. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel, and I will see you next time.